Welcome SEO tool users, marketeers, content promoters and different bloggers. Let's see what is SEMrush. Come on, let's see. So what is SEMrush? SEMrush is an all-in-one tool suite for improving online visibility and discovering marketing insights. So this is a very favorite tool among the SEO users. These tools and reports are able to help marketeers that work in the following services: SEO, PPC, SMM, keyword research, competitor research, PR, content marketing, marketing insights, campaign management. So you can see that there are several fields this SEMrush tool is useful. So there are other areas and there are different tools under SEMrush under which we can work on. The other areas of field of expertise are, come on, it is keyword research, it's on-page SEO, competitor analysis, content marketing, local SEO, name any of them. You can see that the SEMrush tool is vastly built for all types of niches and also types of services. Rank tracking, social media management, link building, competitor SEO analysis, paid advertising, PPC keyword research, website monetization and many others. So these are all the things that the SEMrush tool can do. Now let's dive into the SEMrush 2020 key new updates that have occurred in 2020. Come on, yes. Ultimately, the way you use SEMrush depends on your specific goals. See, each individual blogger, each content marketeer, the marketing expert, the agency gurus, and the different SEM bloggers, and also different SMM experts, social media managers use this tool for different purposes. However, most digital marketing goals require three steps: measuring, improving and reporting. These are the three things that every marketer would like to do. SEMrush can help you do all the three no matter what you... Hello SEO viewers. So in today's video we are going to see about the top SEMrush 2020 product key updates. So in this the last year, 2020, we have seen a lot of key SEMrush 2020 product updates. So some of them are keyword overview, keyword gap analysis, domain overview, two-factor authentication, the improvement of authority score, the backlink analytics, organic research, Google Data Studio integration, position tracking, traffic analytics, toxic score, advanced score, backlink audit, share of voice, cannibalization report, powerful site audit, list management, local business, algorithm changes, traffic journey, market explorer, content market tool kit expansion, social media tools, extra tools, agency growth kit, Prowly, Sellerly and OST integration. So these product updates have made the SEMrush tool a more powerful SEO, SMM and SEM tool. So the SEMrush has been being useful for content optimization for marketers and for backlink analysis to find traffic sources, to analyze content in order to find keyword positions and position rankings, and for site audit and many other features. So now let's see the key SEMrush 2020 product updates that have occurred. So before we go in ahead and see the what are the different SEMrush products that have been updated, let's see what are the major impact in our SEMrush databases. So if you compare the 2018 to 2020 SEMrush product features, we have seen that there were only 2 billion keywords in the SEMrush database in 2018. This has been updated to 20 billion keywords. So what a figure, 20 billion keywords in 2020. So in the in 2018 there were only 419 million domains in the domain database of SEMrush. But in 2020 you can see that it has doubled, and it has come into 825 million domains. And also the geo databases, the countries, different countries for traffic sources and keyword analysis and backlink analysis, there were only 113 geo databases in 2018, but this has been updated to 142 geo databases in 2020. So what this shows the improvement that SEMrush has made in 2020. So now let's see what are some of the improvements in 2020. The first and major improvement in 2020 is the new branding. So the Semrush logo has changed a lot. The Semrush logo and design has changed a lot. So Semrush SEO tool is, it is integrated with its new logo and design. You can see that in the above figure that the Semrush logo and design has changed a lot. At the bottom you can see the Semrush logo with a fireball and an orange. So the visualization of new components can be seen in the new branding. The symbol of fireball is a symbol of energy fuel that markets fuels marketing mechanism. So another important feature is the brand communication with the different color palettes and soft graphics that come with Semrush branding. So the new logo and other designs have made Semrush a unique product. And you can also see the lot of changes that have been taken care of. With the hot orange color is the preferred logo. And also the construction pencils and the protective field have made Semrush branding a very unique product. Now let's see what are the different pricing and plans of Semrush. So in 2020 there has a lot of changes in the Semrush pricing. So after 4th January 2020, if you have upgraded from a free plan to a new plan, there are three basic plans here: Pro, Guru and Business plans. So out of these three business plans, if you can see that the Pro plan is costing about $120 per month, the Guru plan is costing about $230 per month, and the Business plan is costing around $450 per month. So these are all on the billed monthly basis, and each one has a different unique features. So if you see the rest of the features and the updates that have been occurring in 2020, only some of them are available in the Pro features. Other features are available in Guru and Business plans. So you have to check each plan before you buy in order to get your required requirements. For example, in Guru plan we have the content marketing platform, historical data, extended limits, Google Data Studio integration, which have been the new product updates for the Guru plan. So similarly we have a business plan where there is an API access. So the Pro plan is easily suitable for freelancers and startups and in-house marketers. And if you want to go a little bigger and as a small business, a medium business unit with over 200 to 1 million 1 million page views or visitors per month, then you can go for the Guru plan. So these are the different plans and pricing where you have the common man or SMB or the agencies can take up these plans. So now let's dive into the different 10 key updates that Semrush has made in 2020. So the first and key update is the security feature. So if you have seen that in 2020 Semrush has made a key security feature, that is the two-factor authentication. So this two-factor authentication is a better security feature and extra protection for the Semrush user account. So a 6-digit code will be sent to you via email or SMS or using Google Authenticator app before a login. So this is an extra protection in addition to the username and the password. So you have double protection for your Semrush user account. So this will make your account more secure. So this is how you can see that Semrush two-factor authentication policy is here. So here you can enable this two-factor authentication here. You can enable the two-factor authentication. And there are three options here with email, SMS and Google Authenticator app. If you are using the Google Authenticator app, you have to install that app, and for 60 seconds a particular code will come to you, and again after 60 seconds that code will change. So these are the three protections or the two-factor authentication that has been provided as an additional security feature for Semrush user accounts. So what is the second update? The second update has been about the keyword overview. So keyword overview is one of the tabs in the Semrush user account or the feature in Semrush user account. So in this keyword overview, we can see that keyword manager. So this update, in the second update of keyword overview, we can see that the keyword manager has come into the picture. So what does this keyword manager do? The keyword manager collect keywords not only from the keyword magic tool, but other tools. So this keyword manager is a new updated form of the keyword magic tool that provides more keywords and from different databases and from other different tools. And this keyword manager is integrated with the positions and position changes in the organic research. Organic research is another feature of this SEMrush tool. So in this feature, this keyword manager is also been integrated. And another important view in the keyword overview. So in the keyword overview feature, we can also see the global volume metric. Previously, we were able to see only country specific database. Only we can see only country specific data about the traffic search volume or backlinks or the number of the SERP positions, etc. For only a particular country or geolocation, for example, US, UK, Canada, only you can see. But as a whole, if you want to see the traffic search volume for global search volume, you can see in the current keyword overview. Next, we can see the top 100 Google SERP results. So instead of going to the directly going to the Google website and seeing what are the different results for the top 100 for a particular keyword, we can directly see the 100 Google SERP position here itself. For each position or for each URL that appears in the Google search engine ranking positions, we can see the backlinks, referring domains, search traffic, keywords, etc. We can also see that there has been addition of feature called SERP features and questions. SERP features and questions have been added to the keyword overview report, and we can also do a bulk analysis of different keywords. So we can import about 100 keywords at a time, and we can analyze all these keywords at one particular time. So this bulk analysis makes it easier for our marketeers and content promoters to do analysis of 100 number of keywords at the same time. So we can all this way we can also import the keywords from Google Analytics and search call using Excel and CSV reports. So this is a typical keyword overview report. So here you can see the typical keyword overview report. So if you see for that, I have searched for that particular keyword as Xbox. So if you have searched for Xbox keyword, I can see that in the overview report, I can see the volume. What is the total volume for this particular keyword in the US database is 1.5 million. And the keyword difficulty, this which is also have been updated very recently, is 95%. So it is a very difficult keyword to rank for. And the CPC is around $0.66 and the competition is around 0.91. So the important change or the update in 2020 is the global volume metric. So if you can see, the US database has only 1.5 million. But if you combine all the countries that are searching for this particular keyword, it is 5.8 million. So here you can see that US, Brazil, Mexico, UK and Germany are the countries that are having the major, bringing the major chunk of the traffic to that particular keyword. So we can also see the different SERP features and the trends, and also you can see the keyword variations. So the keyword variations can be seen here, which has been suggested. So we can see that there are 2.5 million keywords that have been suggested here. And another important update here is the questions. So the questions that are related to this keyword is like, how much is the Xbox Series X? When did the Xbox One come out? When does the new Xbox come out? So these are some of the questions that you can be done as a frequent FAQ structured data element that will help improve the content promotion. So the volume is also can be seen here. The different volumes for these questions we can see here. You can also see the related keywords like Xbox, com, Xbox, Xbox, Xbox. So these are, though they are not relevant, some of them are like around 6,338 keywords are related keywords are also shown. In addition, we can see the SERP analysis, the top 100 positions of or the URLs in the search engine ranking positions can be seen here. So we can get a detailed analysis of a SERP breakdown analysis of each URL in this ranking position report using this GET metrics. So now let's come to the update number 3, the keyword gap analysis. So the keyword gap analysis will let you find out what are the keywords that are missing, and you can improve upon your content strategies to make your content more powerful and is a useful marketing tool. So the marketing strategy can be updated with the typical content with a weak and strong strong keywords. So that will improve your domain authority and page authority. So this keyword gap analysis will help you find the right keywords that help bloggers and small medium businesses. Using this keyword gap analysis, you can find out the semantic and related keywords from competitor domains. And also these, you can research these keywords from your competitors, not only from the main domains, but also from the subdomains and subfolders. The top opportunities feature is an addition to the 2020 update of Semrush. So we can see that different filters have been updated here. And the keyword overlap graph. So the keyword overlap graph, we can compare our root domain or a subdomain with against four domains. So this overlap graph will tell you what are the common keywords that are there, and also we can compare all the related keywords that are missing. So we can compare different four, at least five domains against your root domain. So using the filters like missing, shared, unique, strong and weak, we can find out the related keywords. So now let's take a typical example of keyword gap analysis. So this is a screenshot of the keyword gap analysis feature. So if you typically see that the database is for United States and for the desktop device. So if you see the top opportunities. So the top opportunities is a key new update for 2020. You can see here what are the missing missing keywords or the weak keywords for your particular domain. Say for example for moz.com is the for which I have compared against. So if you see that Bing search engine, Google domain, these are some of the keywords that are missing with the traffic volume. And this is another important graph here. So the keyword overlap graph here is shown here. So for a particular domain, moz.com, I have compared against four different domains: ahrefs.com, seroundtable.com, searchenginejournal.com and wordstream.com. So if you see that the keyword overlap graph is shows what are the different keywords that are common here. So for example, this orange and pink, if you see here, so this this union will show that it's what are the common keywords and what are the keywords that are left over. So here like that we can see what are the common keywords to two domains or three domains and are the four domains or five domains, and you can see what are the missing keywords, then you can optimize this content. So similarly you can see here the filters are mentioned here: shared, missing, weak, strong, untapped, unique and all keywords. So if you see that the weak keywords, for weak keyword details, if you see that Bing search, so in the Bing search the position rank positions are being given here. So Wordstream, out of the five domains, the Wordstream ranks the highest with seventh domain. So similarly Ahrefs ranks at the ninth position. So Ahrefs can compete with Wordstream to get into a better position by optimizing the content with related keywords and semantic keywords and backlink analysis. So we can also see the keyword difficulty, CPC and the competition and the results, number of results here. So the most number of update 4 is the domain overview. As we've seen here, the domain has also plays a main role, and a domain authority score or the domain ranking factor has a very influential on the traffic of your search engine traffic or the organic traffic. So in this domain overview, you can see the worldwide traffic here. We can also see the different data related to organic search, paid traffic, backlinks related to domains. And also the competitive data of subdomain and subfolder analysis against a particular domain can also be seen here. We can also compare the root domain and subdomain of different domains. So this is also another additional feature. This is also useful for comparing keywords in slash blog type of subfolders. So normally what will happen is a site will have a product website, and the main page will be a landing page. But the blog page will be different, which will be on another subdomain. So you can where all the content will be there in the blog blog subdomain. So now when you want to compare one particular domain with this blog domain, we can do that using the subdomain feature. So now let's see a screenshot of this domain overview. So this overview will show that the authority score. This authority score is a new feature again. This authority score is also has been updated in 2020. So this authority score for this particular domain is 76, which makes it a very unique domain and a powerful domain. It is 76. What is the organic search traffic? For the worldwide traffic, you can see that for the worldwide is another key update in 2020. You can see that the organic search traffic is 1.7 million keywords for this domain keyword, and the paid search key traffic is 18.5k keywords. So this so many keywords are coming are having traffic for this particular keyword over worldwide, and the number of backlinks are 31.2 million. And so like this, you can also distribution by country. What is the organic worldwide? You can see the traffic share is 100% or 1.7 million here. And if you want to see in detail for each country, for example, US, for the domain moz.com. For US, we can see that 35% of its traffic comes from US and 22% of its traffic comes from India. The organic traffic graphs and the organic keywords graphs also an indication of how the changes have taken place over a period. The organic research will also show you what are the top organic keywords for which there is traffic to this particular domain. And also the organic position distribution. So how much percentage are there in the top three keywords, how much keywords are there in the 4 to 10 position for that particular domain in the Google search positions. And similarly, we can see that for the top 100 positions of top 100 positions, how many keywords are ranking, how much percentage keywords are ranking in the Google database. Now on the update number 5, we can see the backlink analytics. So using the backlink analytics feature, so this is another tab that appears in the Google in the SEMrush product. Whether it is the Pro plan or Guru plan or Business plan, so some of the features are available only in the Guru and Business plan. So please check it before you go ahead. And so you can see that competitor backlink profiles can be seen using the backlink analytics. And also using with this backlink analytics, you can find out what are the missing URLs or the 404 URLs that are there on a particular domain. So now when these type of URLs are present, we can find out the backlinks for that particular article URL or the post URL, and you can replace it with a relevant content. So you can ask the request the webmaster to change the URL pointing it to this 404 URL. This is known as the broken link building strategy. So this analysis can be useful to find out these 404 URLs and make marketing strategies for improving your link building. Similarly, you can web outreach specialist. If you are a web outreach specialist, you can also do web outreach to different domains using this method. The toxic score is another feature where which indicates the health of the backlinks. So the toxic score indicates the health of the backlinks, whether the backlinks are of a good profile links are coming from spammy sites or from very bad sites. So now if your toxic score is very low, then it indicates that there are no bad links and most of the links are good links. If it is very high, it means that your link profile is not that good and you have to change by reaching to the current webmasters. Using the new target pages report, you can find out the active, broken, new, lost backlinks. So this is the typical backlinks report for a moz.com. You can see the overview and which is being comparing with 5 domains here. So the moz.com is being compared with 5 domains, and you can also see the backlinks, anchors, referring domains, referring IPs, indexed pages, competitors. So the authority score for each 5 number of competitor domains can be seen here, and the referring domains, the list of referring domains to all these referring domains, which also are RDs, which are also called as RDs, are a very important feature for backlink analysis can be seen here. For example, if you see that Search Engine Journal has the majority of the referring domains. Next comes moz.com, and so these are the two major major domains that are having the highest referring domains. Similarly, the backlink types, whether it is text, image, or form or frame, can be seen here. The type of backlink types, link attributes, you can see here, and we call the top categories of referring domains. So for the particular industry, whether they are coming from which industry, also we can be seen here. So the next number of update is called as the position tracking. So you can track the position of the keyword in the search engine ranking position with using this position ranking tracking tool. So this position tracking feature is another feature in SEMrush account. So there have been updates to this position tracking keywords. So keyword position matters a lot. So the share of voice feature. The share of voice feature is the new feature which links the search volume and the estimated traffic. So this feature, the new feature, share of voice feature, links the estimated traffic and the exact keyword search volume. So you can know how much you can improve upon. So the cannibalization report is another important feature where you can see that whether different number of pages are competing for the same keyword. Say for example, for a particular keyword, if there are 2-3 pages are competing, then you are losing the link juice. So instead you can merge these two keywords or split these the same page into 2 or 3 pages to make effective content optimization. So this is a cannibalization report. And devices and location reports will see the position tracking for city based or the country based or at a very sub level low level based localized reports. Export scheduling of position tracking reports. Then also the another important feature is we can schedule the position ranking reports of different keywords into an Excel sheet or Google Doc using this feature. Now let's see the screenshot. So the position tracking here, you can see here the competition map. So you can see the number of keywords. What is the competition map for in the position tracking feature? So here you can see that that WordPress is at a very high level, and also the quantcast.com is at a very low level. So the in between the searchenginejournal.com, these are the competition map. So we can see the different competitors for a particular keyword. So if you can see that I have uploaded a database, keyword database of consisting of 33 keywords. So out for these 33 keywords, you can see the competition map. So for these 33 keywords, I have uploaded. So for the 33 keywords, you can see the position tracking. So all these 33 keywords, WordPress is ranking very well here. So you can see the competitors here. The WordPress ranking is ranking for the majority of these keywords for visibility. And for about 28 keywords, it is ranking high. And for some of the other keywords, like for example, sitedown.com is ranking for about 7 keywords. And kinsta.com is ranking for about 20 of this keyword. So in this way, you can upload the about 100 keywords at the same time and see the different position tracking features. So this is the position tracking feature where you can see the pages, different pages for those the keywords are ranking. Say for this particular WP beginner URL, you have 8 keywords that are been ranking. And again, the estimated traffic, average position. And you can see also this URL from WP beginner is ranking for 2 pages or for 2 keywords. For 2 keywords, it is ranking out of the 33 keywords. Now let's see the update number 7, the site audit feature. So the site audit feature is one important feature where you can see the authority score. Authority score, it indicates the authority of the site, as mentioned before, is also been updated. The power of backlinks is can be resembled in this authority score. Another important feature is the site health score. So this site health score and toxic score are more related, where it indicates whether there are any errors or any warnings are there for that particular site, and you can improve upon the site on-page site and issues, on-page site issues. The markups report is another update feature in the site audit feature. And similarly, core web vitals. Now let's see this feature. For example, the site audit overview will show the site health score. So the site health score is 80% with the number of errors as 43, warnings as 140, and notice as 520. So now if you can see, you can also see the other reports here. Crawlability, HTTPS, International SEO, and the two new updated features are the markup and the Core Web Vitals. You can see the markup score is about 88% and the other rest features. So now if you want to see the markup features, so what are the markup features that you have seen? See the next screenshot. So this is the markup feature that has been updated in 2020. So if you can see that the markup score is about 88%. So we can see the pages with markup. So with markup, about 83% of the pages are there with the markup. And pages by markup type, whether it is JSNLD or MicroDot or Open Graph or Tita Guards can be seen here. Similarly, the valid structure elements, valid structure data is there or not, it can be shared for 83% of that data. Structured data items, and also what are the different types of structured data or the schema types. Site link search box are there for 82, breadcrumbs are there for this, and article schema is there for something, review snippet, software app, like this. So the software apps have some errors. So the invalid structure element on the software app schema. How to is good for four of the elements. So next, we can see the benchmark your website against reports. So this audience overlap is another good feature of the SEMrush updates in 2020. So here you can see that for different domains, competitor domains of Phi, you can see that audience overlap. So how much traffic is being getting to overlapping for each of the domains. So that what are the shared audience you can see for this using this audience overlap. So the next update number 8 is the local SEO. So the local SEO is nothing but how your a business or their particular agency or a particular individual professional is being ranking in a local your local area. For example, if you are saying the San Francisco area, in the San Francisco area, how is your lawyer business, or how is your kitchen business, how is your food business, or how is your shoe business being running in a local area? That rankings also can be seen in the form of local listings. So these updates have been made, like the list management tool, expanded geo database, and the local ranking reports, review management, and local ranking heatmap. Let's see the screenshot. So this list management tool, say for example, I have taken a business name as Jeller Law. So these data you have to provide initially in order to know the whatever the listings that are there. So the for the country I have taken as US and business name is Jeller Law, and the street address, zip, and phone number have been given. So now using this list management tool, this list management listing management tool is one of the new key updates of 2020 for the SEMrush tool on local SEO purpose. So you can see that you can easily update the local directories. You can see the update the local you can directory listings. So you can say whether you are present in your business online presence is there in 20 updates, youth issues is for fair, not present in 27 of the directories. So you have 89 potential listings for one location. So they're like this data can be read. For example, in Bing, this business listing is present. In Apple, it is not top directory, state of this directory is relevant to your business. And you can submit it to this directory to Apple and Amazon Alexa from here using the listing management tool. So you can see also the keyword positions in the local heat map. So this is an important feature, the local heat map. You can see that 1, 3, etc. So in those particular areas, the local areas, what are the different positions, keyword position for a particular keyword in this local area for your business listing. And the update number 9 is the traffic analytics. So the traffic analytics is another feature that helps the SEMrush tool. So you can do subdomain analysis, and you can also find the top traffic driving channels, traffic marketing strategies, user engagement metrics using this traffic analytics. You can also see the audience insight reports and the traffic journey reports. So traffic analytics, you can typically overview, you can see that the competitors are mentioned here, and for each traffic, how much visits you are getting, unique visitors you are getting, the pages per visit, average visit duration, and the bounce rate. Here you can see that majestic.com is having the lowest bounce rate. If you are we can see that what are the different sources and also the unique visitors that can come in for this page. So the traffic journey report etc. can be seen. So for this traffic analytic feature to be noted, you have to again purchase a particular CA add-on, competitive intelligence add-on, which is costing around $200 per month. So then you can see the traffic journey, top pages, geo distribution using this traffic analytics. So this is the traffic analytics, benchmark your website. So traffic journey. So what is the typical traffic journey? So how much direct traffic is coming to your domains? How much referral traffic? How much search traffic? So this is the organic traffic we are getting here. How much paid traffic is coming to each domain can be seen here. Similarly, the traffic sources. You can see what are the input sources that are coming to your particular domain. Say Rakuten.com, what are the traffic sources? You can see that the top sources are the Google organic and the Google paid traffic, Google ad services that are coming from which the traffic is coming to this Rakuten. After visiting this particular domain, how much traffic is going to another domain? Say the Walmart. So people majority are going after leaving this site, are going to Walmart. Next they go to Google.com. So this is a traffic journey report can we also be seen once you subscribe to the CIA add-on. And the update number 10 is the Market Explorer. So this Market Explorer shows the growth quadrant with the top industry places. So you can in the Market Explorer you can find out what are the industry trends and the key benchmarks. So we can find out what are the key benchmarks that can be seen here. So where the particular traffic is coming from a particular industry trend or industry In industry niche, we can find out from where all the traffic is coming. So, for example, from finance. If the traffic is coming from finance, or if it is coming from computers and electronics peripherals, or if it is coming from boutiques or from fashion industry, or if it is coming from arts, and different categories are there, and different industry niches are there from which we can find out from which the traffic is coming. And we can do a market analysis of up to 20 domains. And we can also do this benchmarking report against 4 domains. We can also compare the traffic counts, traffic sources, key earnings, characteristics. So this typical market overview will show the growth quadrant so of the industry. So this industry will show you this growth quadrant is a major important update in the market overview feature of the Market Explorer of the SEMrush tool. Here you can see the game changers, leaders, and other two quadrants where you can see that where your particular domain lies. For example, small SEO tools lies in the game changer industry or quadrant, game changer quadrant, and the leader of this industry niche is the SEMrush.com. So like that you can understand the market management and market analysis of a particular domain. So the next, finally these updates have been over. Let's see what is the content marketing toolkit. So there have been updates to this content marketing toolkit. So this content marketing toolkit is another important feature where you can do content promotion and content optimization, and content keywords can be gathered using this content marketing toolkit. So this toolkit has the following features: topic research, SEO content template, SEO writing assistant, brand monitoring, post tracking, and content audit. So using these all features, you can do a content optimization and content promotion. So the SEO writing assistant is a plugin and an add-on for Google Docs, where you can write the particular content based upon the guidelines that have been given by the SEMrush tool, based upon the top 100 ranking URLs. So this SEMrush tool will provide different different rules and guidelines using this 100 top ranking URLs. So using which you can get a good score. For example, you can see here the topic research. The topic research, if you find out for Windows 10 HTML, so this is the mind map of related keywords where you can find out. So the social media toolkit. The social media toolkit is another addition to the SEMrush SEMrush tool, where you can this is a useful toolkit. You can see that content marketplace and social media analytics tool, social media ads tool, etc. can be seen for different social media platforms. So for let's see, for example, these are the different social media platforms you have to connect before you gather data: Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Google My Business, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube. If you have all these accounts, you can connect these accounts to this particular social media toolkit. And in this social media toolkit, you can, once you connect them, you can create ads. That is the another feature. Facebook ads and Instagram ads can be created right from here, from the social media toolkit, once you have added them, these accounts have been added them. And other SEMrush updates are Agency Growth Kit, Sellerly, Proly, and SEMrush integration with Yoast. These are the other updates. So using the Agency Growth Kit, you can do customized reports. So customized reports and special reports that can be given to your clients. So client access can be given to this to your SEMrush account once they have a SEMrush user account. So then the reports can also be shared along your members or the clients, which will be useful, and it can be customized also. Similarly, Amazon sellers have a particular product known as Sellerly, so where you can improve your traffic channels and find new customers using this Sellerly. Similarly, in order to improve the digital PR or public relations, you can have the SEMrush has acquired a product known as Proly. So using this Proly, you can have a digital PR can be improved. Similarly, Yoast is a SEO plugin for WordPress. So this is a very useful plugin which is being used by 5 million users. So now if you can insert a parent keyword, you can get related keywords for that particular keyword from the SEMrush keyword databases. So you with this link up can be done using the plugin. SEMrush and Yoast are integrated in the 2020 updates. So this is a Sellerly, and this is also the report customization using the agency toolkit, growth toolkit. So the customization of remotes. Thank you for watching this MDesh 2020 updates and hope you have a great day. Thank you.